Ali Ünal can't sleep or eat because he can't get the images of the dead and dying out of his head. I'm feeling terrible. I can't sleep more than 2 hours a day. It's just like in the Perfect Storm movie where the guy knows he's going to die and he's only worried about his children, he says. Ünal walks away in tears. He is a business partner and manager of the Istanbul nightclub. On New Year's Eve, he was right outside as terrorists entered. This is Ali, falling over a railing as the gunman shoots everyone around him. He survived because the gunman thought he was dead. Bullet holes and blood still remain days after the attack that left 39 dead and 69 injured here. So do piles of clothes and shoes of the victims. From what we can see, this is the area that seems to have the most bullet holes, and the holes are huge. But surprisingly, there aren't that many considering all the shooting that happened that night. And that is because the terrorist was targeting people one by one by one. The owner, Mehmet Kulkarsan, was just up the Bosphorus when he was told his club was under attack.
All my life finished in that time.
You thought your life was over when you heard this?
Yeah, when I heard that my life is over. I feel like that because all that client, all that people is my son, my daughter. I always did my job like this.
He says his legs buckled beneath him as the gunfire and blast captured on this video emanated from his club. Days later, Mehmet is racking his brain trying to figure out what he could have done to protect all those people. Was there enough security, do you think?
You know, for our guard, are you talking our guard? We have no gun. You know, there is a law. If you have alcohol place in concert in somewhere, you cannot. They cannot give the license for the gun. But we are living with the terror. They have to change this law. This is stupid.
Two of his unarmed guards were shot and killed, along with other members of his staff. He says the gunman went about his killing spree with ease and operated like a professional soldier, even blasting bullets into a small gas canister trying to make it explode, but it was empty. The scene of his once glamorous club on the Bosphorus makes him sick to his stomach now.
I'm not sure, you know, if I didn't open, they will be successful. The terrorism gonna be win. You know, but still 39 missed people is on my shoulder. I feel I don't know what am I gonna do it.
He says he will leave that decision up to his staff, men and women, some of whom perished, others who saved lives during the worst moment in this club's 16-year history. Sara Sidner, CNN, Istanbul.